Will pigeon pose wreck your knee? This tends to be a pretty common claim out there, and while I understand why the claim is made, I don't think that biomechanically the claim is accurate, and I'll explain why. So first of all, I understand that, again, the reason that the claim is made is because we look at pigeon pose and we think, oh, well, the hip, this pigeon-like hip needs to be in 90 degrees of hip external rotation. And if someone doesn't have 90 degrees of hip external rotation, then we must steal or borrow that movement from somewhere else. And that can often be the knee. And therefore, we can wreck our knee because of that. So that's usually like the reasoning. Now, it is true. It is true that most people, like hardly anyone, has 90 degrees of hip external rotation. The average amount of hip external rotation is generally like if this is about my end range. So on this leg, you know, maybe I'm to 70 degrees or so. On my right leg, I have less. So here I can go to about here. So maybe that's like 50-ish degrees. But in any case, that's not 90 degrees on either side. And most people don't have 90. But here's the deal. If we don't have 90 degrees of hip external rotation, we don't necessarily borrow it by wrenching on our knee. And if we did, that would be highly uncomfortable. What actually tends to happen in most people's bodies is their bodies naturally self-organize to move at some other area of the body so that they still embody a shape that resembles pigeon, but they're not getting there by wrenching on the knee or by forcing the hip into 90 degrees. So let me show you what I mean. There are three ways that this commonly happens. So the first way that someone's body can naturally self-organize so that it doesn't require wrecking the knee joint would be instead of having this front shin parallel with the front edge of the mat, people often, they don't even realize it. Like again, the body naturally tends to do this, but that shin might angle back a little bit. It might even angle back a little bit more. And the more back the shin goes, see it, the more it goes back, it starts to go, it goes ultimately here. And this is like zero hip rotation. So basically you can see that the further forward the shin goes, the more that that hip rotates. So the further back the shin is, the less hip rotation is required in the hip. So that's one way the body can self-organize is just by not embodying that parallel and by having the shin angle backward. And no one ever said that pigeon pose has to be done with that shin parallel. So it's totally fine to do it that way. Now that was the first way. Now, a second way that people's bodies often self-organize in pigeon pose to avoid wrecking the knee, if they don't have 90 degrees of hip external rotation, is that they simply roll onto the pigeon-like hip. So something like this, where instead of their pelvis being, quote, square to the front of the mat. So like this would be a totally squared pelvis. They have the pelvis turn off to the side and more of their weight is on the left hip. And then they come into pigeon like this, where this right hip is rolled up. So this is another way. It's very common that we see this in pigeon pose. And this may even allow the person to have more of the 90 degree shin because they backed off the hip range by rotating at the pelvis like that. So this is way number two that people tend to self-organize out of wrecking their knee in pigeon. And then the third way is that people often, if they do like want to place the shin parallel, and if they do want to square the pelvis forward, they may naturally find that their pelvis elevates up off the floor. See how I have space here? And so they may embody a pigeon with like floating hips like this, or they can prop, and we tend to see this quite often, people prop underneath that pigeon-like hip with a block or a bolster or a folded blanket, something like that. And when the pelvis is higher, the thigh angles down more, and this requires less hip external rotation. So this is yet another way we self-organize. I'm still in pigeon pose, but it's just like slightly shifted. My body's organized itself so that I can be in the pose and not have to have 90 degrees of hip external rotation and not be wrecking my knee. So those are three of the most common ways that we see people's bodies self-organize so that pigeon pose doesn't wreck the knee. And that's why I think that in general, that claim isn't really supported. So it'd be a good recommendation to maybe just like let go of such claims so that we don't plant fearful thoughts in people's minds, because those actually can ironically lead to pain down the line. If you appreciated this content, subscribe to my channel so that you can stay up to date on all of the content that I share.